academic but lost, having skill but lost, very strong but lost, athletic but lost, charming and beautiful but lost. And what can you do? We're looking for the way to get to heaven. We're looking for the way to spend eternity with God up on high, but the man is lost. And then that's why Jesus Christ came. That's why he suffered on the cross, so that this talented boy, this talented girl, and so that this skilled person that is lost in life, the Lord will save the lost. Look at Luke chapter 19. In Luke chapter 19, I'm reading from verse 10. It says, "For the Son of Man is come to seek and to save that which was lost." And that's you. And no matter what you know, no matter what you have, no matter what's your pedigree or your parents, what they have, if you are lost, you are lost. And it doesn't matter what else you know in life. But Jesus suffered a lot, number one. Number two, he saved the lost. And then he will recover you. I said he will find you. And when you run into the arms of Jesus and say, "Praise the Lord, I am saved. I am not lost anymore," every door will open before you. Because you are no more searching for this and searching for this and searching for that. Because now he has found you. And you know, when he finds you like that, salvation is yours, joy is yours, and then victory is yours, and success is yours. And then you're able to get your destination and the dream you have. I have a lot of young people, I have a dream. If you are lost, where can you find the dream? He says, "I have a goal, I have an ambition, I want to get here, I want to get there." But you are lost, you don't find the way. It is when you find Jesus and Jesus finds you, and there's a connection between you and Jesus. This lost boy, this lost girl is recovered. He will recover you tonight. The moment you just raise up and say, "Yes, Lord, I am here. I don't want to be lost anymore. I don't want to be lost without you." Jesus comes, it's your life. 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 You've heard the passage of scripture, John chapter 3 verse 16, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever, that's you right there, that whosoever, that's you right there, whosoever believes in him will not perish." Romans chapter 5. Romans chapter 5. In Romans chapter 5, I'm reading here from verse 8. Romans chapter 5, we're looking at verse 8. It says, "But God commended his love toward us." God commended his love toward us, in that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us at the cross, at the cross. And the burden of my heart rolled away. Because, you know, it was at that point when Jesus Christ died for us, he showed his love. God commended his love towards us, in that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for the ungodly. In verse 9, it says, much more then, being now justified by his blood, we shall be saved from wrath through him. That's eternal wrath, eternal punishment will not be your Lord anymore in Jesus' name. You know, I wish I had the time. I'll come there one by one and shake your hands and say, "Congratulations, you will not be lost anymore." I say, "Congratulations, you will not be lost anymore." And maybe one of these days, if you give me chance, you know, I say if you give me chance, because if I, you know, come in your midst now, then all the children, you know, I will get to you. I said I will get to you, but you're in a hurry, and you want to mob me and tear my clothes, and I say, okay, I cannot be, but if you give me the chance and you stay where you are, then I come over here, I say, can I shake your hand there, and you know, and I just go like that, you know. I've been in the adult church for a long time, I'll tell you, I love you so much, it's like I should just remain in the youth church, you know. The other time, praise the Lord. The other time, somebody said, "I heard you were 70. I said, "Don't say that again. I'm 17. I I just want to be as young as you are. I said I want to be as young as you are. And I want to spend a lot of time with you. I'll be coming back. He showed his love. He showed his love. While we were yet sinners, he died for us. And because he died for us, he showed that love. That love is yours right now. You can be saved right now. All your sins can be forgiven right now. Number one, tell me out loud. He suffered a lot. Number two, tell me out loud. Number three, tell me out loud. Number four, I sought the Lord. I sought the Lord. I sought the Lord. The man was dying already on the cross. I mean, this thief on the cross. And then the other thief was making fun. But, you know, this other thief was wise. He was wise. He said, I know I'm a sinner. I know I'm lost already. I know this is my last chance. If I close my eyes in death now, I will never see glory. I will never see the light. And therefore, he sought the Lord. He sought the Lord. Look at this. It's in Luke chapter 23. Luke chapter 23. Luke chapter 23. We're looking at verse 42. Luke chapter 23, verse 42. And he said unto Jesus, Lord, remember me when thou comest into thy kingdom. Remember me. He sought the Lord. You see, all that Jesus did on the cross of Calvary, if you didn't seek the Lord, if you're not praying, if you come to the retreat or you come to the, you know, this beautiful gathering and beautiful wonders of the cross and also the special miracle time, and you're just roaming about here and there, and you're not seeking the Lord, although he did everything for you, how will you get them? That's why you need to sit down there, and then you call on the name of, remember me, it's me. You mention your name, I'm a sinner, I've done this, I've done this, but remember me, just like that thief on the cross, remember me. And then look at the answer in the next verse right there, that's in verse 43, that's verse 40. And Jesus said unto him, verily I say unto you, today thou shalt be with me where? In paradise. He sought the Lord, I sought the Lord. Number five, I saw the light. I saw the light. I saw the light. That's what we're singing about when it says, at the cross, where I first saw the light. I saw the light at the cross. We're all in darkness, in the darkness of sin. We're all in darkness, in the darkness of evil. We're all in darkness, in the darkness of the night. Well, in darkness, you know, there are some creatures that they don't operate in the afternoon. They don't operate in the light. You know, sometimes, you know, you come back home and, you know, the toilet had been closed or locked and all that place, everything is locked. All of a sudden, it's now in the evening, about 7:30 and 8, and then you just open the door, and then you turn on the light, and then you see those creatures, running here and there. What do they call them? Tell me now. Ants and cockroaches. You know, they are nocturnal kind of creatures. They only operate in you see in the night, they don't see in the day. But and some boys are like that. They are boys of the night. They are girls of the night. Only in the night they operate. And then when you turn on the light, suddenly, then they are shocked and they are surprised. And I say, are you a cockroach boy? Are you a cockroach girl? Why are you so shocked and surprised when we turn on the light? What were you doing? You are like a cockroach. But I will not be a cockroach. I said, me, I will not be a cockroach. And so then you come out of the light, and then you come into the light, because Jesus died for you. I saw the light. Tonight, you will see the light in Jesus' name. At the cross, where I first saw the light, and the burden of my heart rolled away. It was there by grace, by faith, I received my sight. And now I am telling me, happy all the day. Salvation brings happiness. That happiness will be yours in Jesus' name. I saw the light. In John chapter 8. John chapter 8. I'm reading verses 11 and 12. John chapter 8. And we're reading from verse 11. And reading from verse 12. John chapter 8. Are you there already? She said, no man, Lord. And Jesus said unto her, neither do I condemn thee. Go and sin no more. That's what the Lord is telling us. I said, I've died for you already. I bore the punishment of all your past sins. Every bad thing you've done in the past, I've carried that for you. But now, it says then in verse 12, speak Jesus again unto them, saying, I am the light of the world. He that followeth me shall not walk in darkness, but shall have the light of life. You will have that light in Jesus' name. Number one, tell me. He suffered. Number two, tell me. He saved the lost. Number three, tell me. He showed his love. Number four, tell me. I sought the Lord. Number five, I saw the light. Number six, I share his life. I share his life. Calvary brings you near. The cross brings you near. Christ brings you near. He said, look at what I have. I have a beautiful life. Can I share this with you? He said, look at what I have. I have life. Can I share this with you? Look at what I have. I have a victorious life. Can I share this with you? Life without sin. Life without sickness. Life without danger. Life without calamity. Life without an end. Life that lasts forever. Life that endures. And Jesus says, here is my life. I want to share my life with you. I share his life because of Calvary. Look at John chapter 10. John chapter 10. I'm reading from verse 10 and from verse 11. John chapter 10, reading from verse 10. It says, the thief cometh not but for to steal, and to kill, and to destroy. But I am come that they might have, tell me, that they might have life, and that they might have it more abundantly. Look at verse 11. I am the good shepherd, and the good shepherd giveth his life for the sheep. I share his life. I share his life. Number one again. Number two again. Number three. Number four. Number five. Number six. Number seven. He now supplies your lack. He now supplies your lack. He now supplies your lack. No more lack in your life. I rejoice. When you find Jesus, you're going to find abundance. When you find Jesus, you're going to find plenty. When you find Jesus, you're going to find abundant life. When you find Jesus, all things become yours in Jesus' name. I pity young people that do not have Jesus when they are young. You see, by the grace of God, it was when I was young that I found the Lord, that I got salvation. And then before I went to university, I just, you know, somebody prayed to me, and then I went to, you know, a gospel church. I became born again. And since that time, you know, think about that time before university days, just coming out of secondary school, and then, you know, that salvation, that abundant life, and the joy of the Lord has continued until this time. And I want you to have it exactly as I have it. And, you know, can the pastor brag? I said, is the pastor bragging? I'm just telling you so that you will be like me and you will go beyond me. What is the person I'm talking about there? I said, you'll be like me. And then you will go beyond me in Jesus' name. That day, when I surrendered my life to the Lord Jesus Christ, everything turned around completely. And now he supplies all my lack. And it's good to supply all your lack. Look at Romans chapter 8. Romans chapter 8. And I'm reading here from verse 32. Romans chapter 8, verse 32. It said, he that spared not his own son, but delivered him up for us all, how shall he not with him also freely, because he paid the price already, freely give us all things are yours in Jesus' name. Second Corinthians chapter 8, I'm reading from verse 9. Second Corinthians, we're looking at chapter 8, verse 9. Blessings are yours. Salvation yours, healing yours, deliverance yours, happiness yours, dominion yours, success yours, victory yours, triumphant yours in Jesus' name. Tell me, how will you not be happy? Of course you are happy. I said, of course you are happy. Happiness belongs to you because Jesus belongs to you. 2 Corinthians chapter 8, I'm reading from verse 9. 2 Corinthians chapter 8, verse 9. For ye know the grace of our Lord Jesus, that though he was rich, yet for your sake, that's you there, for your sake he became poor, that ye through his poverty might be, tell me, might be rich. You're rich in Jesus' name. Chapter 9, verse 8. Chapter 9, verse 8. You know, the way you sometimes, how do you remember, Pastor? The other one is chapter 8, verse 9. This other one is chapter 9, verse 8. 8, 9, 9, 8. 8, 9, 9, 8. 8, 9. What next? 9, 8. That's how I remember. You will know Bible. I say you will know the Bible. Second Corinthians chapter what? Verse what? And verse 8, and God is able. Your God is able. I said your God is able. And God is able to make all grace abound toward you, that ye always, always, always having all sufficiency in all things may abound in every good word. Look at all the, you know, what we read there, and mark the words all. All, then always, then all. Look at, I'm going to read that again. And notice the words all, always, and all. Look at this. It says, God is able to make, tell me, all grace, all grace, all grace. And then it says, abound. That means something overflowing toward you. And it's you in particular now. You are the blessed boy. You are the blessed girl. I pass that to you. Nobody will take that away from you in Jesus' name. Then it says that she always, always, having all sufficiency in all things, may abound to every good work. It supplies your lack. It supplies your lack. Look at what we get when we say at Calvary, at the cross, where I first saw the light. That's the place I share his life, and now he supplies my lack. Rise up and let us pray. This is the time now, the time of blessing, it has come. The time of blessing has come. The time of blessing has come. Remember, he suffered a lot. He suffered a lot. And it was for you. He did that. Just close your eyes and then raise your voice. So, thank you, Lord Jesus. You suffered a lot for me. You suffered a lot for me. You carried my guilt away. You carried my shame away. You carried my punishment away. You suffered for me. If you were the only sinner in the world, Jesus would have suffered for you. He suffered a lot. He suffered a lot. He suffered a lot just for you. And then he saved you, the lost. Thank you, Jesus. I am saved. I repent of my sin. I turn away from my sin. And I turn to the Lord Jesus Christ. And now I am saved. He showed his love. He loves me like no other person can love me. He loves me like no mother, no father, no friend, and no companion can love me. He loves me a lot, for God so loved you in the world that he gave his only begotten son, that if that the moment you believe, you will not perish, you'll have everlasting life. And I saw the Lord. You're seeking the Lord right now. You're seeking the Lord right now. And his salvation will be yours. His salvation, his salvation, his salvation will be yours. And then I saw the light at the cross where I first saw the light. I saw the light. I saw the light on the face of Jesus. I saw the light that leads me to the way of heaven. I saw the light of his glory. I saw the light of his word. I saw the light of salvation. He is mine. I'm not walking in darkness anymore. I have seen the light. I share his life now. He has given me his life. My life was corrupt. His own life is clean. He has given me his life. My life was dirty. His own life is pure and righteous. He has given me his life. He has given you the life. Now I share his life. And now he supplies all my life, because God will supply all you need according to his riches in glory by Christ Jesus. He now supplies all your lack. He now supplies all your lack. He now supplies all your lack. You can thank the Lord and say, I thank you, Jesus, because I know you are mine. In Jesus' name we pray. Why don't you just raise up your hand to the Lord? If you are just receiving the Lord, if you have received the Lord before, if you are a child of God, you are thanking the Lord. Just say, I'm just happy. I'm just happy because Jesus belongs to me and I belong to Jesus. Everything I will ever need, everything is mine right now. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray for every boy, every girl. I pray for the teachers and the leaders, all these people who are sacrificing here to make this war for the young people, to be connected with Jesus. Oh Lord, I pray your suffering on the cross will not be in vain on any of us in Jesus' name. And Lord, you save the lost, and I pray that your salvation will come to that heart right now. Your salvation will come to that heart right now. The salvation with joy, the salvation with victory, the salvation with new life, the salvation with eternal life. Let it come to everyone right now in Jesus' name. Oh Lord, I'm thanking you because it's not only that you have shown your love. And I pray that those who feel lonely, those who feel rejected, those who feel dejected, oh Lord, I pray, no dejection here. No rejection here. Oh Lord, I pray, all that loneliness you will take away in Jesus' name. I read of, you know, some young people, because they are so lonely, nobody loves them, that's what they think, and they commit suicide. That spirit of suicide, I command you, come out in Jesus' name. There is love in this kingdom. There is love in this house. There is love waiting for you here. He loves you. His love will surround you. His love will overshadow you. His love will be underneath you. His love will back you up. His love will go beyond you. His love will be inside you. You'll be filled with his love. You'll be saturated with his love. You'll be surrounded with his love. I pray that that love of God will come upon your life in Jesus' name. All the tears of loneliness, wipe everything away. All the tears of regret, wipe everything away. Jesus loves you and Jesus cares for you. Oh Lord, I pray that your light now will shine. In every heart, your light will shine. In every heart, the light of victory and the light of success and the light of healing and the light of satisfaction and the light that shows the way, and we keep on walking and we keep on to the top of the mountain. Oh Lord, to the top of the ladder, show them the light. Show them the light. Show them the light. They will never miss their way in Jesus' name. And that victorious life of yours, that life of yours that is radiant, that is excellent, that is wonderful, that is powerful, that life of yours that will never be defeated, give that life to everyone here. Boy, receive this life in Jesus' name. My daughter, girl, receive this life in Jesus' name. Abundant life is given to you. Eternal life is given to you. The life that will never fail. The life that will never fail. The life that will never fail. It is given to you in Jesus' name. I pronounce all the lack of your life supplied. All the loss of your life supplied. All the limitations of your life supplied. You'll be happy in the morning. Happy in the afternoon. Happy in the evening. Happy as you go to school. Happy as you come back. All the provisions of heaven will be at your disposal in Jesus' name. No sickness in your life. No disease in your life. No calamity in your life. Every negative sin that the enemy has brought in your life, I cancel everything in Jesus' name. Rise up and walk. Rise up and live. With confidence and with courage and with faith, move on. You are going to get to that top in Jesus' name. Every day of your life, every week of your life, every month of your life, every year of your life, your lack supplied. Your lack supplied. Your need supplied. And I pray every time I see you, the joy of the Lord will be your strength. all of us who are here, everyone, I pray that right now the Lord will do something in you. And will do something that you know at Calvary, at Calvary, at Calvary, at Calvary, all your needs are now supplied. I thank you, Father, because I know you have answered. In Jesus' name we pray. And everybody said, thank you very much. I'll see you again.